Now here's that feature I promised from Philip Keitan. Small-scale farmers are slowly embracing the use of technology in their farming practices. A small group of farmers in Marimba, Githongo and Kibiricha areas of Meru County have embraced a flying technology called the Third Eye. Now the technology is a sensor mounted on a drone that enables farmers to detect pests and diseases 10 days before they can see the damage caused with their own eyes. On this week's episode of The Next Frontier, Philip Keitan visited these farmers and tells us more.
Since independence, Kenyan farmers have practiced traditional kind of farming, largely due to the small size of their farms. Despite these farmers being very hardworking, they have not been able to realize any economic boom. But now things are changing as these farmers embrace precision agriculture, or smart agriculture, which is largely based on the use of advanced technology in the management of crops in a bid to increase output without compromising quality.
We have some frying. LGB ones. Then from there we go to the office, we process, we use some two softwares, one called ICE and another one QGIS. Then at the end results, we get a map.
Now farmers in Marimba, Githongo and Kibiricha areas of Meru County have turned to scientists to help them find sustainable solutions to improve their precision farming. Now the scientists, with the help from the Netherlands Development Organization SNV, have introduced flying sensors, also known as the Third Eye, which is mounted on a drone to help farmers detect pests and diseases before they can actually see the damages caused with their naked eyes.
Flying sensors monitors crop stress. That is, it can either identify nutritional problems, stress, water stress, crop diseases, or crop pests.
According to Professor Bansi Mati from the Water Research and Resource Center, WAREC, of the Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology, precision agriculture or smart farming is based on the use of advanced technology in the management of crops to increase output without compromising on quality, with the need to maintain the balance between cost and quality has made drones particularly attractive for smart farming.
This particular drone is mounted a special sensor which uses the same wavelength, the same science as a satellite. So literally it's like you are capturing satellite data at greater detail, and which we are in charge of configuring, choosing where to fly, how high to fly, how much detail we want. So that's the beauty of this flying sensor or drone used by the farmers.
Professor Bansi also insists that drones are becoming a critical tool for farmers. Many farmers are already benefiting from drone technology, and that Kenya has just scratched the surface of what this relatively new technology can do for agriculture in Kenya.
The equipment was donated by one of our partners, SNV, in Netherlands, who brought the sensors and even trained the technicians you have seen here. Then as we support with the science and the research to link that science to what the farmer can do with that information.
The Third Eye project uses well-tested low-cost flying sensors that provide high-resolution partial information to smallholder farmers beyond the visible spectrum. The flying sensors are equipped with near-infrared sensors that detect crop stress about 2 weeks before the human eyes can observe this.
We are taught about the sensor or the flying, the Third Eye. And I decided, I felt that I have to use it for my betterment of my production.
typical drone package comes available with three types of software. That includes the drone, camera, and the brain that flies the drone. When connected to a computer, the computer can tell the drone what areas to fly over.
First of all, it is fast, very quick information. Look at this is 4 acres of land. So in a split, like, was it 10 minutes? You are able to literally, you know, get very detailed information with one flight of the sensor.
Tulikutana na hao watu wa land hire, wakanielezea vile tunaweza sensa mashamba yetu, na wakakuja, wakatusaidia sana. Kwa sababu tumejua ile mandao tutakuwa kitukitumia, fertilizers, ambaye hatukuwa tunajua. Na sasa tunaona wametusaidia na tutaendelea vizuri na hao.
According to Dr. Abraham Haile of the Netherlands Development Organization, SNV, drones are used for collecting high partial and temporal resolution images over a wide range of regions in a very timely manner. When the farmers need information quickly and in a hurry, the drone can provide it promptly.
Client sensors, basically, it has a bigger agenda. The bigger agenda is that, like you saw today, the young people, making the young people interested in this kind of activities, in the extension work, because with the flying sensors, you can cover up to 100 acres. And then you have to go back, process the map, and see exactly where the problem is.
Aile insists that in agriculture, drones are used in the thermal imaging. Multispectral sensors are mounted on a drone, which gives farmers a valuable picture of how their crops, specifically crop canopies, performing under different growing methods. Imaging data from a drone is a good indicator of crop vigor and canopy stress.
With the third eye, you can detect problems like stress, water stress, diseases, pests, nutrient deficiency. You can detect these problems 2 weeks before. You can detect it with your naked eyes. What does that mean? It means you can solve the problem before it creates a lot of damage to your crop.
Multispectral sensors allow a farmer to precisely apply needed water, fertilizer, or pesticides only where they are needed, instead of applying the same amount across the entire field. These sensors acquire imagery in bands that can sense vegetation health and identify areas in the field that are nitrogen deficient through a process known as normalized difference vegetation index.
Small-scale farmers are now embracing technology like the third eye, or a drone that is mounted with cameras with sensors that now enabling these small-scale farmers detect pests and diseases 10 days before they can be detected by the human eye. Philip Keitany for The Next Frontier.